welcome you this morning to Metropolitan Community Church of the Blue Ridge.
I hope that you're ready for some worship and ready for some singing quietly into your mask as we sing. What's our song?
This is the day.
This is the day. Somebody's got to clap. I have no rhythm.
This is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made, we will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day, this is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. We will rejoice, we rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made, we will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day, this is the day.
We welcome you this morning, like I said, to Metropolitan Community Church of the Blue Ridge. We're glad you're here with us in person today. And those of you that are here with us through Facebook Live, we're glad for you to be here too. If you'll look in your bulletin, there's some announcements. Our Family Promise opportunity is coming up again. Board applications are available at the church website. And also today and next Sunday, you are welcome to go around upstairs and upstairs to see if there's something you might want as a memento of MCCBR. Are we asking them to take it today or tag it today?
Either.
Yeah. If you want to take it with you, take it. If you can't take it today, tag it, but you'll need to take it by the 10th. We appreciate you doing that. Because there's lots of little things sitting around. In the sanctuary, you'll see 4,222 candlesticks. So feel free to decorate your home with some of those candlesticks. We tried to remember those things that were specially given in memory of someone, but you might want to check on those things. There is a flower arrangement up at the choir that has been claimed, so please don't take that. What else? I have an announcement, something about the building, but I'll share that during our prayer time. Any announcements that I've missed or need to share with you? All right, well, let's continue in our worship as we sing and listen to God of Wonders. the sermon, yes. Prayer request and praises time. We always start, of course, with our prayer request and praises for our frontline workers, our people who are out there taking care of us and making sure the world continues. So if you continue to remember all the different categories of people we've mentioned in the past. I think it was last week or last Tuesday, Sean asked us to pray for Dylan, her co-worker's brother, who was in a really bad accident. Well, he's home now, but he has a long, hard recovery. So she asked that we continue to keep Dylan in prayer. Rosemary's girlfriend, Kim, wants prayers for her nephew, who's having open heart surgery coming up soon. A couple of our friends from Charlotte sent us a prayer request. Denise's sister-in-law, Kathy, who has kidney cancer. They had the kidney removed this week. They're waiting on results of that. Donna Nicastro is having some pretty important heart issues. And Sherry Long is having a lot of heart issues. We had let you know there was a contract on the building, and that did not work out. The person who was going to do it had grandiose plans, more grand than the city was willing to talk to him about, plus the fact of the building being a historic landmark. But we're supposed to be getting another contract from our realtor tomorrow. So keep in prayer that that goes through and that that will be a smooth. If it does go through, this building will continue to be a church. So pray about that if you would. Don't forget today, look around if there's something upstairs that speaks to you or you want as a memento, please feel free to take it. You can make a donation if you want to, but that's not required. The more you take, the less we have to get rid of. And while you're doing your praying, pray that we can find a place we can afford that will cover all the needs we have. Besides the sanctuary, besides a space for our children, one of our biggest requirements is a place for our food pantry. Because it doesn't, like James says, it doesn't do any good to pat somebody on the head and say God loves you if they're hungry. So keep that in prayer. Other prayer requests or praises. Patty?
My neighbor has been diagnosed with cancer, several different spots in his body. Mm-hmm. And I don't know what treatment or if anyone's going to be able to do, so please remember him.
Okay, Patsy's neighbor. Paula?
I phone in part, if that's the phrase.
Yes.
And I put my application for it, but I've got a few stumbling blocks to go through. So just pray that things go right, and I get it.
Okay, that God slams open the door for your apartment. Praises for Bonnie shared with me and Patsy shared with me this morning. Praises for you as a community of faith who stood with them through these last weeks. It was a blessing to be able to share with the family on Monday at the service and to let them know that Patsy and Bonnie have a church that loves and cares for them. Also on Wednesday night, I was glad to be a part of the showing of The Eyes of Tammy Faye and on the panel for that. I got a chance to speak to my dear friend, Steve Peters, and Jeffrey was there, Rhonda was there, and there were about 40, 50 people in the community, so it was, again, a way of getting our name out there. Any other prayer requests or praises? Jeffrey.
My car is sick.
Oh, no.
I got sick this morning on the way here.
Oh.
So, let's pray it's a simple illness.
Okay. Did it get you here?
Yes.
Okay. I just was wondering if you and Rosemary need a ride back, and so.
That's yet to be determined.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Lori.
I think it is Sherry and Lisa's 20th anniversary, isn't it?
It's an anniversary. I'm not sure if it's. Yeah, it's probably 20. Yeah, it's 20.
I just wanted to wish them a happy anniversary.
Absolutely. Happy anniversary to Sherry and Lisa. And what a place to have to spend it.
I know.
Hawaii. Yes, it's funny. I remember the first date they went on. Gosh, somebody's old. Anyhow, anything else? Just remember, if you get home and you go, I should have said that, set it in for Tuesday. We're also glad to have the Foster girls back here in town today, and Ivy. Would you pray with me? Oh, loving God, you just bless us in so many ways. When it looks like a door has been slammed shut, you open another door. We ask that you help us to praise you in the in-between times, in the hallway, and the waiting times. Be with each of these situations that have been mentioned, the people that are sick, that are facing surgeries. We'll rejoice when Paul is able to tell us she has the keys to her new apartment. We ask, loving God, that you just help us to trust you and to trust your timing, even when it's not something we like or the way we want it, because if it's your timing, it's the perfect timing. Bless us during the sermon and music and communion today. May your word be blessed, and may each of us leave here today having been blessed in some way, little or small, and especially bless that blue car out in the parking lot. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Good morning.
Morning.
It is October.
Yes.
Which is the time of my favorite holiday. If anybody has any leftover candy bars at the end of the month, please feel free to bring them back. October is also Pastor Appreciation Month. So when the plates come around, give as you're able to the church. And if you would like to give a gift to Pastor Catherine, just mark either in the memo line of the check or on the envelope, if you're donating cash, just mark it for Pastor Appreciation. And we will present it to her on Halloween. So, double good stuff there.
Candy bars are acceptable also. I'll split them with you.
Okay, good deal. Dr. Pepper would work too, I'm sure. So please give as you're able. Thank you.
Just slip away and breathe his name.
Your name will be glorified. In your name we pray. Amen. Somehow or another, I managed to miss the very first prayer request that I had written down, and that's for Pat. She fell on Friday, missed her step, and ended up in the street. She was sent flat down in the street, but she cut her head and several other scrapes and bruises and spent some time in the ER, but she's going to be okay, she said. She just was way too sore, you know, the second day. Just need a minute. That's a very special song to me. Scripture today is from the 8th Psalm, and amazingly, I'm not reading it from the Message Bible today. As much as I love the Message Bible, I need it a little more traditional today. Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory in the heavens. Through the praise of children and infants, you have established a stronghold against your enemies to silence the foe and the avenger. When I consider your heavens, the works of your fingers, the moon and the stars, which you have set in place, what is humankind that you're mindful of us? Human beings that you care for us. You have made us a little lower than the angels and crowned us with glory and honor. You made us rulers over the worlds of your hands. You put everything under our feet, all flocks, herds, animals of the wild. The birds of the sky, the fish of the sea, all that swim the paths of the seas. Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. If you're a Michael W. Smith fan, you may have heard that over and over and over. It's one of his best songs you hear. And don't worry, I'm not going to sing it. I've had that pleasure already this month, last month. But we do need to think about how majestic God is. There's a part of me that likes to make God very tangible, something I can understand and something I can visualize. But I always have to remember that God is that and so much more. Someone once told me anytime you say God is, in another word, you've limited God. Because God is beyond our explanations, beyond our wonders, as the song said earlier. Just beyond anything we can imagine. Beyond so much we can't really imagine. If you get caught up in too long, your head just goes, you don't know which way you're going. But we are called, both in the Psalms and in other places, to praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And if you looked in your Bible, you would see that the first praise the Lord is L-O-R-D, all in capitals. And that's referring to Yahweh, the word that the Hebrews used for God. Yahweh is what when Moses said, who are you? And from the burning bush, God said, I am who I am. I will be who I will be. That was Yahweh. So there's that massive idea of God. And then it says that God is our Lord, capital L-O-R-D, small letters. Lord meaning our boss. I think I told you before about my friend that had a bumper sticker that said, my boss is a Jewish carpenter. We have to realize that not only is God this massive, wonderful thing, person, being, entity, but God is also the one that wants to be in charge of our lives, that wants to be our boss, wants to guide us. Now, there are good bosses and there's bad bosses. Amen?
Amen.
Uh-huh. Some of you have had them. Some of you may have been them. but there are times, if you have a good boss, that boss understands what's going on. Whenever I've been the boss in a business and sometimes in church, I want to know how things go from the ground up. I want to know where the trash gets dumped as well as what the important things of the big wigs would be. And God is our boss, and that God cares about the smallest of things in our lives and the greatest of things. What I love about our prayer and praise time, because sometimes you'll think, why are they praying about that? And then there are times like climate change and world wars and famine that are just so massive we almost can't put words to it. And so we're told that we praise the Lord for God's glory. God is glorious simply because God is our Lord. And God is majestic. Now, we all, many of us grew up with that Santa Claus king sitting on a throne with the long white hair, the long white beard, and the robes and the jewels. And, you know, even as a child, I thought, I don't think so. But there's a different way to be majestic that has nothing to do with robes and jewels and crowns. Some of us have been majestic in our own times. We've been just the right person at just the right time, doing just the right thing that God needs us to be doing at that moment. There's majesty in that. There may not be trumpets. You may not have walked down the aisle of a huge cathedral, but there's majesty in that. And so we praise God because God is majestic in the big ways and the little ways. We praise God for God's grandeur. You say, it sounds like you're talking about two different things. I am, because God not only cares about the little things, God cares about the big things. And I love how this psalm, you know, the psalmist had such a simple life compared to ours. The psalmist pretty much had the outdoors, the animals, maybe some contact with family. But the majesty that they saw of them was the stars, the sounds around them. Now, we're just inundated with noise, right? Just inundated with noise. It may not be in your own house, but it may be somebody cutting down a tree. It may be the interstate, the roads going by. So many times we don't really understand that kind of quiet majesty. But God created the big things and the little things. It says, when you created your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moons and stars. And then the psalmist says, wow, what am I to that? Why do you even consider me? If you've ever been in some of the really majestic places, and it doesn't always have to be in a big national forest, it could be in your backyard, but you see the glory of God and you wonder, and you still care about me? You made me, of all the things in the world, you made me, unfortunately just one of me and just one of most of you. But you cared about and made me. And God cares about the big things as well as the smaller things. The smaller things. The psalmist is real aware of where he is in the pecking order of the world. Because he says, you made me a little smaller than the angels, a little lower than the angels. But you've crowned us with glory and honor. Crowned us with glory and honor. There's a hymn, crown him with many crowns. One time at camp, the music director said, now sing it like you really want to crown him. I laughed, not everybody else did. But crowned with honor and glory. You give us the ability, God, to be an honorable representative of you. You give us the opportunity, God, to, you know, we joke sometimes about shining our halos, but you give us the opportunity to do things that make you proud, that make you happy, And not only that, but you've made us rulers. You've made us rulers, and this is where you can really get into some climate control sermons here. Because if you remember in the book of Genesis, God gave over to Adam and Eve control of all the animals and all the trees, but one. All the animals. Now, I've heard people say, why did God allow stink bugs to survive? Some of you would say, what about those snakes? If you live in Florida, you might wonder about the alligators. But they're all a part of God's creation. And we have the ability to rule over them, which means don't go where they are. Help them on to glory when you need to. But we're commissioned as rulers. And that's responsibility. That's not just the power to give and not give life. Rulers direct. Rulers help. Why do you think we can sit here in this service today with three dogs, and at the moment, knock on wood, nobody's barking. Nobody's running in circles because they've had somebody say, don't do that. Don't do that. Why can we have a toddler sitting here just enjoying his grandma's ride back and forth? Because he's been here since he was a baby. And he knows there's things you do during church and things you don't do. Now, I don't like to say he's been ruled, but he's been taught. Mm-hmm. And we have that responsibility. We have that responsibility even to adults sometimes. You know, there are people that will come into church, and they may never have been into church before. And they don't know what you should do and shouldn't do. That's why Paul told the early Christians, now, husbands, make your wives be quiet, set them off in a corner. Why? Because in the Jewish faith, they had not been allowed in corporate worship. They had to be off to the side. So when they got to come to church, why are they doing that? What's that for? What are you supposed to put in that plate? There are all kinds of questions, but we have the ability to rule and teach and encourage people. And then lastly, it finishes up with, we praise God because of God's greatness. Because of God's greatness. Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. How majestic is your name. How often do we praise God by our words or by our actions or by the way we treat other people? How often do we praise God in that? You don't have to be running down the street all the time saying, praise God, how majestic, praise God, how majestic. That will get you a visit somewhere, probably. But we do have the ability to give God the honor and the glory and the praise in times when we can. In times when we can, and when we can't say it out loud, we can say it right here. You know, at the service on Monday, it was a blessing to see Patsy's family all there encouraging one another and friends being there and hearing some of the stories about Kathy. You know, when you praise one another, in a sense, that's praising God because we are God's creation. So the next time you feel like it's all gray skies and you're going to go to the garden eating worms, poor pitiful me, remember it's not just your life. It's a life that God took the time to create. Many of us shouldn't be sitting here right now. I think about Rhonda and some of her heart stuff. She could have been gone like that. Michael's been through some really scary times. Many of you have been in life-threatening situations, but by the grace and glory of God, you're sitting here today. And that is a very important thing. That's a very important thing. So give God the glory. Give God the praise. And remember how majestic is our God. Amen.
Amen.
I'm sure for the disciples that night in the upper room, things didn't feel very majestic. They were worried. The Romans were wanting to kill them. Jesus had already told them he was going to be killed. But they came together, and because of the word of God and because of the ceremony they celebrated that night, they were exposed once again to the majesty of God. And Jesus took bread from the table. And he lifted it to heaven and he gave praise for it and thanks and broke it and blessed it. And said, this is my body, which is broken for you. Take and eat of it, each of you. every one of you. And in the same way, he took a cup from the table and lifted it to heaven and gave thanks for it and blessed it and said, this is my blood poured out for you as a sign of a new and everlasting covenant. My blood poured out for the forgiveness of all sin. Take and drink of it, each of you. And we remember these promises and works of Christ, and we say that Christ has died, Christ is risen, and Christ is coming again. Hallelujah. Christ's body broken that we might be whole. The love of God shed abroad in all our hearts. As you go forth this week, sisters and brothers, not only remember how majestic is our God, but remember how majestic you are. Remember how majestic your brothers and sisters, your friends and family, and even strangers are. Why are they majestic? Because God took the time to give them life. It's our job to help each other enjoy the living of the life we have. Amen. God bless you.